Good morning, students. This is next topic in acids and bases, that is how strong are acids and bases solutions. That means how acids are bases strong in solutions. So that can be identified by using pH indicators, simply pH value. That means by using pH value, we can say that whether the substance is strong acid or strong base, or are weak acid or weak base. So first we discuss pH of acids. The pH of acids lies between 0 to 7. That means for any acid, if you take any acid, that pH value of acids is between 0 to 7. And for strong acids, the pH value lies between 0 to 4. For strong acids, the pH value lies between 0 to 4. But for weak acids, the pH value lies between 4 to 7. 4 to 7. That means if the pH value lies between 4 to 7, then those acids are weak acids. If the pH value lies between 0 to 4, those acids are strong acids. For strongest acids, the pH value is equal to 0. That means if the pH value is 0, those acids are very stronger. That is about pH of acids. Next, pH of bases. Here, for the bases, the pH value is lies between 7 to 14. For acids, it is lies between 0 to 7, but in this case, the pH value lies between 7 to 14. For strong bases, the pH value lies between 10 to 14. For strong acids, 0 to 4, but strong bases, it is lies between 10 to 14. For weak bases, the pH value lies between 7 to 10. For weak acids, it is lies between 4 to 7, but in this case, it is lies between 7 to 10. Important point, if the pH value is equal to 7, then the substance is considered as neutral substance. That means it is neither acid nor base. So these are important points. So simply, for acids, the pH value lies between 0 to 7. Here I just show one small chart. For acids, this is acid part. Between 0 to 7, that is acid. Between 7 to 14, that is base. In deeply, between 0 to 4, that is strong acids. Between 4 to 7, that is weak acids. These are pH values. 0, 4, 7. These are the pH value. Between 7 to 10, that is weak base. Between 10 to 14, that is strong base. So you just remember this one. Again, these points will be coming in 11th class. Class 11, chemistry chapter. So simply, if pH value lies between 0 to 7, that is acid. 7 to 14, that is base. Between 0 to 4, strong acids. 4 to 7, weak acids. 7 to 10, weak base. 10 to 14, strong base. Next, what is pH? That is the main concept. Now we are discussing how acids are strong and bases in solutions. Now, what is acid? What is pH value? What is pH? Here the definition is very important for 1 mark question. pH, the negative logarithm of H plus, this square bracket indicates concentration. This is called concentration. So the negative logarithm of H plus concentration is called pH. The negative logarithm of H plus concentration is called pH. That means mathematically it is represented like this. pH is equal to minus log H plus concentration. This square bracket indicates concentration of H plus ions. So by using this expression, we can say one important point, that is, actually if negative sign is not there, between pH and H plus directly relation is there. That means if H plus concentration increases, pH value is also increases. If minus negative sign is not there, but here negative sign is there, so automatically that relation will be changed. That means if H plus concentration increases, pH value decreases because of this sign. If H plus concentration decreases, pH value increases. So these are very, very important point. If H plus concentration increases, then pH value decreases. Here one more point is there. That is, if H plus concentration increases, then acidic nature also increases. That means acids contains H plus ions. If those H plus ion concentration increases, then acidic nature, that means acidic nature increases. That means strength of acids increases. Then it becomes strong acid. Automatically pH value decreases. So this is very important point. H plus concentration increases, acidic nature also increases, but pH value decreases. Acidic nature increases means the strength of the acid increases. That means it becomes stronger acid. One more definition, like as pH, that is POH. In case of pH, the definition is negative logarithm of H plus. Similarly, in the case of this one, the negative logarithm of OH minus ion concentration is called POH. That means, as mathematically, this is represented by POH is equal to minus log OH minus. Here also same concept, that is, here also negative sign is there. So if negative sign is there, automatically the relation between these two is inversely proportional. That means if OH minus concentration increases, basic nature also increases. That means basic, because basis contains OH minus. If basic nature increases, automatically pOH value decreases, because here negative sign is there. If negative value increases, automatically positive value decreases. So the point is, if OH minus concentration increases, basic nature also increases. Basic nature increases means the strength of the base increases. That means it becomes strong base, then but the pOH decreases. In case of acids, H plus concentration increases, acidic nature increases, but pH value decreases. In case of bases, OH minus concentration increases, basic nature also increases, but pOH decreases. Again, all these points comes in class 11 chemistry. So until that, you just remember all these points. Next, very important point regarding pH value, importance of pH in everyday life. Actually, in our body, the pH value lies between 7 to 7.8. This is the normal range pH of human body. In some cases, excess of acid is prevented in our body. In such cases, antacids are used to neutralize the excess of acid. For example, suppose some persons suffering from gastric trouble, that gastric trouble is due to the formation of excess of acid in stomach. In such cases, we should use antacids. If you use antacids, then the excess of acid in the stomach will be prevented. Automatically, we get good health. So the point is, if excess of acid develops in the human body, means that means acidic nature increases. That means H plus concentration increases. If the H plus concentration increases, automatically pH value decreases. That means if pH value less than 7 to 7.8 in human body, then that person gets some disorders. So in such cases, we should reduce the excess of formation of acid. In such cases, we should use antacids. Oh, antacids means the chemicals which are used, or the substances which are used to reduce excess of acid in the stomach, or to neutralize the excess of acid in the stomach. Those substances are called antacids. So this is very important definition for one mark. The substance which neutralizes excess of acid in the stomach, or which reduce the excess of acid in the stomach, is called antacids. For example, MgOH2. This is antacid. Antacid means, that is antidote for excess of acid. The MgOH2 is this is weak base. If you add base to acid, that automatically then neutralization takes place. I told you already in the previous class, neutralization means when acid reacts with base, then salt and water is formed, that is called neutralization. So in this case, if excess of acid is produced in the body, in such case we should add what? Base. Then neutralization takes place, then we will not get any problem. So here this is very important definition. Antacid means the substances which are used to neutralize the excess of acid in the stomach is called antacids. Example, MgOH2S. There are some more example that is BaOH2S, that is also antacid. Beryllium hydroxide, that is also antacids. Next one more point. There are some more points regarding pH value. That is, if the pH of rainwater, generally rainwater pH is 5.6, generally. That's why we should not drink rainwater, because its pH value is 5.6. 5.6 means it is less than 7. That means it has some acidic nature. That is why we should not drink rainwater directly. Suppose if the pH of rainwater is less than 5.6, then that rainwater is considered as acid rain. This is very important point. If the pH of rainwater is less than 5.6, that is called acid rain. If this acid rain moves into rivers or lakes, then the water get contaminated. That river water or lake water becomes contaminated. That means it becomes polluted. Due to this, the survival of aquatic life becomes difficult. That means the living organisms which are present in water becomes, their life becomes very difficult. For example, fishes, frogs, crabs, all these are present in water, rivers. So automatically those life becomes very difficult. Next, if the pH of our mouth is lower than 5.5, if the pH of our mouth is lower than 5.5, then tooth decay occurs. Tooth decay means tooth becomes damaged. This is due to the formation of acids by the bacteria. That means sometimes we take the food. After taking food, we forget to clean our mouth. Automatically, our food is attached. Already, some food is attached in mouth. After some time, that food produces acids. That means the bacteria present in the food produce acids. This bacteria is developed due to uncleaning of mouth with water. That means if we don't clean our mouth, automatically the bacteria present in our food produces acids. If the acid produced in the mouth, automatically tooth decay takes place. That means that acid reacts with the teeth. Automatically tooth becomes damaged. That is called tooth decay. So the best way to prevent this is to clean the mouth after eating food. That means we should clean our mouth, or we should gargle our mouth after eating food every time. So this is all about pH. Thank you.